Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about how if you want to learn software development really well, try to get a job. Okay, so in the many years that I've been creating videos on this YouTube channel, I've gotten hundreds of questions, right? A lot of the times the videos are spawned by a question. Oh, we do the live stream. We used to do them every Monday night. Now we do them every few Monday nights. But I've done hundreds of live streams where we just answer questions for like a half an hour or an hour. The longest was like 2.5 hours, right? I love answering questions. It's like, you know, I'm able to give my opinion on stuff, and other people in the live streams get to give their opinions on stuff. And it's kind of this place where all of us can come together and just sort of talk about, you know, this worked for me, that's worked for me, I haven't tried that, I have tried this, I think this is overrated, all that kind of stuff, right? It's just like one developer talking to another. So, you know, I like those kind of questions. One of the questions, there are a certain type of questions I do have trouble with, which are the quantitative ones, right? Was like, an example of this would be like, okay, if I have an app that has 1,000 downloads a day, how much money will I make? Right? Like, that's a typical question I used to get all the time. And I could never answer it because there's too many variables in the way. It's like, you know, how are you monetizing it? Are you using ads or in-app purchases? If you're using ads, where are your users based? You know, what is your RPM going to be like? How many impressions are you having per session? All that kind of stuff. And there's so many different things in there. It really is difficult to, like, you know, you can't just apply math to it, right? And another question I get a lot is the learning ones. Like, you know, Eric, I'm studying Android development now. How long until I can become an Android developer? And it's like, well, that's, again, more variables. Like, do you want to just produce something? Because you could produce something fairly easily because you can, like, you know, not even consider like a huge part of the language if it's not relevant to what you want to make. Or do you want to get a job? And if you want to get a job, then that's a little bit more tricky because you never know, you know, you got to be a bit more skilled and, you know, they'll come to you with different kind of stuff. Like on a typical day, somebody can come say, we need to, whatever, connect to this API or we need to support this type of phone or whatever. You know, you never know when you're working a job as a software developer what somebody's going to throw at you, right? However, I will tell you this. If you are studying to become an app developer or software developer of any kind, it's a lot easier if you could get a job where they show you how to do it, right? Which sounds, it sounds easier than it is. But like when somebody comes to me and asks me, I'm like, okay, so I want to become an Android developer. I'm reading this book, I'm taking this course or whatever, or an iOS developer or a Flutter developer. You know, how long will it actually take me? And my answer is always like, you know, well, I think you should do enough that you can until you can get a job to where you can learn on the job. I mean, learning on the job is way, way, way better than teaching yourself, right? And, you know, you never like lie to the client. You just like, you work until you become marketable, right? Because when you get to that point, when somebody actually hires you, then it's a lot easier to learn. And it's not because they give you the time to learn it, because a lot of the times you have to learn on the job, you have to make things work. It's because you can't quit. Right? A lot of times when we're teaching ourselves something, I know with me, if I'm trying to learn a new skill, you know, if I could quit, that's like, sometimes that's right there in the back of my mind. Like, oh, I'm never going to get this. I mean, one of the things that I'm really proud of, and when I tell people this, it really impresses them, is that I speak Chinese. That was my job in the army. Like, Wo Hui Shou Yidiar Zhongwen, right? It was, you know, for 4 years, I was a Chinese linguist, and you know, they sent me to school for a year and I learned Chinese. And people say that, go, oh man, I couldn't learn it. I mean, to be honest with you, like 1.3 billion people speak it better than I do. Like, but so, you know, it impresses a lot of people locally. So, you know, when I tell people that, they're like, wow, I could never do that. It's like, yeah, you could if you, like, you know, you had a drill sergeant screaming in your face, or you're like, you know, you had to do it. It was your job. If you didn't do it, it was failure. My first software development job, it was like as a trainee software developer. I had no experience. I went in there and there were days where I thought, oh my God, I can't do this. This is too hard. I mean, this is like Microsoft Access stuff. When I think about it now, I think, I don't know what I was so worried about, but I was thinking, I'm just not getting this. This is too hard. This is like, you know, this is way over my head, right? But, you know, there was also this thing where I couldn't go to them and tell them, I can't do it. I give up, right? Because there was more on the line. I had a little kid at home. I had, I had bills to pay. I had all this kind of stuff. So it was like, whatever I had to do, I forced myself to do it, right? That's the thing about when you get something on the job, right? A lot of the times when I take on a job or I take on a contract, I'll be very honest. I'll say, okay, I have experience with this and this, but I've never worked on this. But I'd be willing to, I'll work as hard as I can to do it. A lot of times they'll give it to me because I'm a hard worker, because that's a little bit there, like behind me. Like if you go in and try to get a job as a software developer and you have no experience at all, like you haven't even cracked a book, that might be a bit more difficult. But if you could go in there and say, okay, I've been working, I've been studying for the last 3 months and produce something. Like that's the big thing. If you're studying, I mean, who cares if you study? Like you read a book, right? But you said, and I created this app, and you get that first job, even if it's not the kind of job that, pays as much as you want to, you get in there and it's something that you increase your skills, increase your level, right? Every single job should be like, the trade-off should be not just financial. Financial, of course, because that's the reason we get jobs. But every job I've had has been, I will give them everything that I know up to this point, and at the same time, whatever skills they have or whatever the new technologies we can use, we build onto that. But the big thing is, and it's something that we tend to forget about when we're learning a new skill, when it's easy to quit, a lot of times we'll quit. That's why it's easy to not, go to the gym. It's easy. Like, I took a 10-week course in Hindi. Talk about learning Chinese, where I had to learn it. Like 10 years ago, I took a 10-week course in Hindi, and it was going to be the start of, like, many courses. And it was just, I just could not pick it up, right? I quit easily, right? It wasn't a requirement, so I dropped it in favor of other things that I was more shiny object syndrome, going off to the next thing. So this is one of those things for those of you guys. This video is basically for those of you guys who are like looking to get into software development, and you're like having a hard time learning. Try to see if you can be marketable. Like work on your CV, work on a few portfolio projects. Get something that you can actually publish and put onto the app stores. I mean, because it's easy to do, right? Get something, publish it, put it out there, and then start to see if you can market yourself. Don't lie. Don't be a fraud, because they'll figure that out, and then you'll just be the worst developer they ever worked with. But if you're somebody that can help them out, can give everything you have, you're quick to learn, then that's the way that I would go. So these are just some of my thoughts here based on my own experience. Some of you guys may totally disagree with me. You may think, no, you need to go to university. No, you need to get, you need to like know the, get an Android book and know it backwards and forwards, know everything you need to know before you get that first job. But a lot of times you don't. You learn that stuff as you do it. You have that practical knowledge which comes from actually working a job. Anyway, this is a bit rambly tonight. I just wanted to share that with you guys, right? Just, the only reason I was able to learn Chinese at the age of 22 was because I had to, right? And when you're working a job and you have to learn a new technology, it's because you have to that you do it. Anyway, let me know if you guys have been in a similar experience. If you worked a software job, when you got that first job, what was your level of skill when you went in there based on when you come away from it? And the answer is going to be obvious. You know more when you leave that job than when you went into it, or maybe you're even still in it. But, how much would you say getting a job gave you skills over actually like going to school or taking a course or reading a book? Anyway, that is it for today. I hope you guys have a great week. Hope you have a great day. That's it for today. I'll talk to you again next time.